I think people have opinions and they want to be involved in different ways.
New at 11, IMPD Police Chief Randall Taylor weighs in on the true crime podcast trend and how they can help solve cases. RTV6 reporter Cornelius Hawker joins us now. And Cornelius, you've been looking at a local podcast that's really been helping to shine the light on an unsolved crime in our area.
Yeah, Mark. Crime Pursuit is one of several podcasts here in central Indiana that's looking at unsolved crimes. And they recently dedicated 3 episodes to the Angie Barlow case. Lauren Van Sickle, right there, has led the efforts talking to the people who knew and still love Angie. All with the hope of getting someone who has information that could help police solve the case to come forward. That's something the police chief says is a good thing.
If it's generating conversations, especially if it's generating conversations from people who have information on that crime and they're going to share that information, then I'll be all for it.
The IMPD detective on the Angie Barlow case just checked in with Angie's family and Lauren last week. And here's another look at the efforts that's happening to get justice for Angie.
Made it all that more real for you to picture that moment.
3 years of work has come together for Lauren Van Sickle.
Once I got involved, there was just no turning back.
Co-hosting a podcast dedicating 3 episodes to Angie Barlow, going over the last night of the young woman's life, looking at the clues Angie left behind.
She arrived to the home. She sent a text and said, you know, here's the address of where I'm at in case I go missing, which sadly turned into a very prophetic message.
Along with that text message, Angie took a Snapchat video as she got ready for the party where she was working that night. These screenshots are from that video taken by Angie's mom, Christina Kramer.
She was our daughter. She was a granddaughter. She was a sister. She's got 3 little sisters who absolutely adored her.
Christina's been the glue holding the family together, staying strong for her loved ones, while also grieving and making sure Angie's memory is kept alive.
Who better to advocate for you than your mom? Because nobody on this planet will ever love you more than your mom.
Here's what we know about the night of October 26, 2016. Several days before that, Angie, who was an exotic dancer at Club Rio at the time, was asked to perform at a private party. This was all arranged through text messages. A friend says Angie had a bad feeling about the party, but decided to do it anyway because she needed the money and felt like she could handle herself. After the text message to her friend and the Snapchat video was posted, Angie was never heard from again. The private party took place at the Landmark Apartments on Indy's north side. Video from security cameras show Angie's car leaving the complex around 3:30 a.m., 4 hours after she showed up to the party. Her car was followed closely by another one. Neither Angie's friends, family, or police believe she was the one driving it.
Are they willing to go to prison for the rest of their lives for people who murdered someone?
Christina is talking about other people who were at the house party who may not have known what was going to happen till it did.
It's come into a time where you probably need to start trying to save yourself.
Until police make an arrest, Angie's family and people like Lauren are committed to keeping Angie's story alive.
Somebody has to do it. The missing and murdered can't speak for themselves.
All the stories we've done, along with the Crime Pursuit podcast, will be up on our website, theindychannel.com, so you can watch, listen, and share, hopefully reaching someone that has information on this case.